Question for the married men. I have a coworker who from day one I met him was very nice, too nice. I'm not a woman to think that every man I meet wants to flirt with me, much less in a professional setting and way less a married man. My first month at this job, I requested to meet with everyone in the team one-to-one to get to know them and discuss if improvements were needed, given that I was new and a fresh pair of eyes. Anyways, everyone else responded to me with, "Let's set up a call," and this one man responded to me saying, "Let's get dinner and drinks to discuss." His response totally caught me off guard and I found it a little weird. I joked with my friends that he was sliding into my Outlook inbox. Anyways, I agreed but I didn't go with just him. I instead took the opportunity to invite the entire team for happy hour. I was too uncomfortable meeting him just he and I fast forward, and he invited to happy hour with other coworkers so I went. He never overtly flirted but he would do subtle things that would confuse me. For example, during one happy hour he casually touched my thigh, didn't leave his hand there, just a brief touch. Then when we were leaving the restaurant he opened the door and guided me out by placing his hand on the small of my back. It was confusing because I couldn't tell if he was just being polite, but at the same time I've never touched any coworker like that. Aside from a handshake or a high five, I've never crossed a physical barrier with a coworker. Anyways, we start hanging out more and he gets more flirtatious. But it isn't overtly or explicit, it was always very subtle. At one point he asked that we never sleep together, and I told him I valued him as a friend and respected the fact we were co-workers, so that would never happen. I also made a point to ask about his family and I met his wife when they had an emergency and she needed help. All to say, we became friends. When I got to know him better, as friends, I asked him why he was flirty when he was married. He said it gave him a thrill to be able to flirty and walk away and go back home to his wife. He enjoyed the thrill but also enjoyed the fact he was strong enough, in love enough with his wife that he could toy at the edge of danger and escape unscathed. He said it proved to him he had a solid marriage. He said he liked to push people's buttons and he got a kick out of it. I asked him if he was worried one day he'd cross a line. He said it was a sobering thought he'd never considered until he met me. Since then we have agreed to keep a distance and avoid any setting that could cause questionable behavior. I told him I respected his wife and valued my working relationship with him to ever consider jeopardizing it. My question to the married men of Reddit is, do you agree or does his logic, above, for flirting resonate with you? Do you flirt, toy with a dangerous line for the heck of it? Does it not make you feel guilt? How would you feel if your spouse did it to you? Does flirting as a married man really make you think your marriage is strong because you can walk away? To me it sounded like his wife was unaware of just how flirtatious he is. She seems very innocent and very kind. He also doesn't flirt overtly, so I can see someone being confused and making a move and him saying, "I'm sorry you got the wrong impression, I was being nice." He's told me how women have come onto him, without him doing anything or saying anything. I don't believe it, and he has had to remind them he is married. Thoughts? Edit 1. I should clarify these conversations were never during work hours. Rather during happy hours. Like I said, I met his family and we became friends. I've always established boundaries with him and ensured to never cross them. But none of this occurred during work hours. However, I found it interesting on how he rationalizes it. He's a scumbag and completely sexually harassing you at work. Tell his wife he's trying to cheat on her. I'm a married guy in a Fortune 500 for over 30 years. I've seen lots on guys behave like this over my career. He's dirty. I always behave like my wife is in the room. Can't go wrong like that. He's testing the waters to see how far he can go. The bigger question here is why his behavior doesn't seem inappropriate to you. And why would you value someone as a friend and a colleague who behaves like this? Pretending to not know what's acceptable or not is a recipe for disaster for any relationship you may have. Flirting, touching, and innuendos are never harmless. He was just giving you lines and you're still eating them up. He's actually still flirting with you by telling you, "Oh, but you have the ability to seduce me, by the way." Stop falling for the bullshit, and if his wife even found out he told you those things, it would probably cause a huge issue already. Nope. He's scum. My wife is all I need to flirt with. I also don't have any female friends of my own. At the most, I'm on good terms with my wife's female friends. I'm not saying you're causing his actions, but these conversations or friendship should have never been allowed by you. You're there to get a job done and then go home. Everyone's feelings and life are none of your concern. He's still responsible for his actions. He's shopping for an affair. He has probably been confronted before, which is why he already has his excuse ready to go. I would be willing to bet he has probably actually had an affair before. People that are looking for an affair tend to not really be concerned if you have met their for some of them it makes it extra exciting that you know each other. It doesn't really resonate with me, and if his wife isn't aware then I don't really think he should be doing it. The more immediate issue is that it sounds like he is a sexual harassment lawsuit waiting to happen. Disgusting. He is a player and you're not the first one he's done this with. He absolutely has cheated on his wife. He does not have a solid marriage. I feel so sorry for his wife. Do not think twice about this and just stay away from him. My 21 male girlfriend, 21 female, sleeping at her new guy friend's place. Sorry in advance for this being all over the place. And possibly long. Knowing me, probably. So my girlfriend, Abby, 21 female, and I go to a college on the East Coast, won't name which because anonymity. We've been together since junior year of high school, we're coming on 5 years. I love her very much. We have been rooming together in student housing for 2+ years now, and besides vacations when visiting family, we've slept together every day. For some context that's important. We have had issues over the past year, getting more intense this semester, about spending enough quality time together. I'm working around 20 hours a week and am double majoring, leaving me with not a whole lot of free time. She has a significantly higher need than me for quantity of quality time together. It's equally and very important to us, but she needs more of it. I of course love spending time with her as well, and oftentimes I find myself sacrificing sleep, time for myself, time put into my hobbies, etc. It's gotten to a point where I honestly was feeling burnt out. She brought up to me that she feels lonely and doesn't feel like her needs are being met in terms of time together. I talked to her about how I'm feeling, and we came to some sort of a compromise and we're seeing how that goes for now. This talk was about a week ago. She is also double majoring, and has joined a sorority this year, which has been absolutely fantastic for her. For irrelevant reasons, she has not had much of a social life the last couple years before this and she has really enjoyed hanging out with her sisters, sorority events, going to parties, etc., which I'm not really a parties but have no problem with at all. Over the past couple weeks, on 3 occasions now, after parties she has been crashing at a friend's, Derek, 21M. He doesn't drink at the parties and picks her up, and then she crashes at his apartment after playing some video games, watching TV. I don't know this guy, they really just became friends recently. I feel uncomfortable with this, one for safety reasons I don't know what his intentions are, she trusts him, but it's only been a couple weeks and I've been on this sub long enough to know people can hide who they are well. She crashes there when she's drunk, she's new friends with him and doesn't really know his roommates. I don't know any of them. Also, if he's driving her just to sleep on the couch, why not just drop her off at our house? It's very close by like 2 minutes away. I asked her and she said she's too drunk to tell him, so maybe she can tell him beforehand, but also they sometimes hang out, TV, video games etc., before going to sleep. She hasn't been as affectionate in the last week or so, and we haven't had sex in about that amount of time too. I have been initiating but she has not been in the mood. She says she is emotionally drained from school, absolutely understandable with her course load and majors, and says she doesn't see it getting better anytime soon. I'm starting to feel kinda sexually frustrated and undesired. Though I trust her, this combined with her spending the night at his place is making me feel uneasy. I have already brought up so I don't want her to feel like I'm nagging or don't trust her. But this is weighing on me and I know I need to bring it up. What should I say, do? Thoughts? It is extremely strange that he's not just dropping her off at her place. She is double majoring in Dick. Sounds like Derek is her new BF. Huge red flags. Your place being so close to the dude. Your girl saying she is too drunk to tell him. The seemingly sudden lack of intimacy and her making you aware she has needs not being met. You've been together long enough to talk about this. I would frame it as you wanted her to come back to your place on such occasions versus making accusations without evidence. Good luck, my man. She doesn't drunkenly forget to tell him to take her home. She actively chooses to go home with him instead. She has told you she feels she isn't getting enough attention in the relationship so she is seeking it out elsewhere. Why doesn't she call you to come get her? Okay, I get being friends but in just a few weeks he is picking her up sober from parties and taking her to his place to crash on the couch? What, besides sex, is his motivation for this? Rhetorical question you need to ask her this. Also, and more importantly, How does she not see this as a boundary violation in your relationship? I mean, imagine a girl picking you up and driving you back to her place to sleep? What partner would ever be okay with this? Perhaps let her get past exams, then talk to her and tell her this stops or you are going to break up. Derek is hitting it. 34, F. My boyfriend, 28, M. Found out about a dark period of my life. Throwaway account as he browses Reddit. I met my boyfriend about 2 years ago. He is handsome, kind, generous and took care of me during pandemic when more than half of employees in my firm were furloughed. 3 years before meeting him, I was a druggie. It was a dark period of my life. The only thing I cared about is getting high and my next shot. I was involved in shoplifting and petty thefts, though I was never caught. I had sex with strangers to get enough to fund my addiction. However, when my friend overdosed, then I got my act together, cleaned up, started taking courses to retrain my skills and was lucky enough to score an employment in a construction firm. Then I met my boyfriend just by luck. I was quite open about my past addiction, except about my sexual encounters to pay for my addiction. 2 days ago, someone found out about us, and sent a video to him of me having sex with two men in a car. I can't recall who filmed it as I was high when I was with these men. In normal circumstances, I wouldn't lower myself to such level. My boyfriend is furious and hurt, and he started berating me. First he wanted to know how many men, and when I couldn't give him a proper answer, and how can I? He started insulting me, called me offensive names and all other insulting words, and even told me that if I have any dignity then I would jump from a bridge. He even asked if I'm abusing any substance just to be high but still functioning. That was very wounding to hear from him. He left to another city for 2 days, and asked me to leave the house before he returns. I don't have any friends with whom I can stay. My family live in another state. This is out of question due to my job. I'm a bit lost. What can I do? And how can I fix my relation with him? I don't want to lose him at all despite of his insulting behavior. Too long did not read. My boyfriend found out about my past and I was not exactly forthcoming about it. It would be something huge for everyone to process, but he definitely did it on one of the worst possible ways. He should know you are a different person now, but if he doesn't want to see it, there's not much you can do. Sadly, sad face. You should not have kept something like this from him. It's coming up in such an ugly manner because you chose to keep it from him, which puts everything about you into question. Is it wrong? Yes. To him, he's seeing this just now, even if it's your past. No one is going to react well to finding out their girlfriend of 2 years hid the fact that she was a prostitute from him. In future relationships, you should bring this up and give the guy a chance to have his reaction when the news is coming from you rather than have a stranger expose the fact that you've been lying to him. Going to be completely honest here, sex work is a stain that stays on you forever. You hid that you were a prostitute from him for 2 years. There's a substantial difference between having a drug habit and being a prostitute. He found out in the absolute worst possible way. This is something you should have told him. There's nothing you can do to save the relationship. There's no magic thing you can say or act you can do to make him get over this. It's an instinctual thing. You lied to him for 2 years, he found out, and now all the trust is gone and the relationship is dead. You have had years to deal with this and move past it, but to him, this all just happened yesterday. Why didn't you tell him? Because you knew this would be the likely outcome. The lesson to learn is not to lie, even by omission. Then he gets a vid of you banging two dudes in a car? Wowzers. I wouldn't have urged you to kill yourself, but I would have broken up ASAP. This can't be solved up. Sorry. Sometimes life decisions have long-term consequences. To men, your sexual past matters as the best predictor of future behavior is past behavior. Although his verbal abuse is unjustifiable, your past choices have consequences. This is one of them. He feels you have purposefully deceived him in addition to behaving in ways that he finds repugnant. There may be no coming back from this. You should give him some time and be gone when he returns. Find a cheap hotel, take a leave from your job and go stay with your family, whatever. You don't want to add to his anger and resentment by making him feel he has to continue to support you or make you homeless. Women care about a man's future, while men care about a woman's past. You withheld the info because you know that most men would reject any potential girlfriend who disclosed escort, prostitution, porn work. He didn't insult you, he wasn't abusive. He was freaking blindsided by your dark secret. Your only option is to sit him down and tell him absolutely everything you can remember. It'll be hard, you'll be upset. Disclose every ugly detail. It probably will not work out well for you. but it's the only way to move forward with him. Accidental anal. Okay, so my boyfriend, 28, and I, F25, have been together for about 3 years. Last night we were doing the deed. He was pretty cross-faded and I was only high and one drink in. Everything was going really well until he accidentally slipped it in my asshole. And it wasn't a he just put the tip in situation, it was rough and deep penetration that wasn't just once. So because I've never done anal, it hurt very badly and I yelled and was shaking. I was having trouble communicating on what had happened but was covering my butt and on the verge of tears. At first he didn't understand what happened and then he asked if he hurt me and I nodded. He was apologetic until I told him he put it in the wrong hole. Then he became not as concerned and tried to finger me while I was still in the fetal position with my eyes closed covering my butt. I said I needed a second and so he went to go make food. To me it felt like he completely dismissed my pain because he didn't think it hurt that much. So I went to the bathroom and of course my asshole is bleeding. So I was then pissed. Not because he did it, because I truly believe it was an accident, but because of his reaction to me. I tried to talk about it and he made a joke and was giggling, so I told him I was bleeding because I felt like he wasn't understanding how much it actually hurt. Still, he went about his business and started watching TV. When this morning rolled around, I woke up pretty upset and still in a little bit of pain. He asked me if it still hurt in a kind of condescending way, and so I re-explained everything to him and he said something along the line of, "You still want to talk about this? Sounds like you're trying to convince yourself that it hurt, not me." So I just shut down and stopped talking, and a few minutes later he apologized for his reaction and not taking me seriously. Which is what I wanted the entire time. I knew that it was an accident, but like, don't act like I am overacting. If I shoved a dick in your unprepared asshole and then was like, "Oh really, that hurt, teehee," you'd feel some type of way too. He said he didn't know it hurt that badly, which is fine, but don't dismiss me. We were having sex under the influence, so I totally am not upset that it happened, and his immediate reaction was upsetting, but there's only so much you can expect from someone who's pretty fucked up. It's just that in the morning he had the same reaction. Do guys just not realize because in porn they just slip it right in? Really, the root of the problem is that I wanted comfort and he did the opposite. What do I say? Has anyone been in the same situation? If it was an accident, and your boyfriend was a good guy, he would not have reacted by dismissing your pain. He would have felt bad. As he did react by dismissing and mocking you, I think we can assume that either it wasn't an accident or your boyfriend is an asshole. Or both. I'm sorry this happened to you. It wasn't an accident. I could explain to you, as a man, why it wasn't an accident, but I don't want to go all not safe for work here. Just trust me. It wasn't an accident. Op, and other women here, 'twas no accident. He just assumed you'd take it like he's watched too many pornos. Has he been low-key trying to do anal, and this was his, "fuck it, I'm doing what I want," moment? If so, I'd question your entire relationship. That's some pretty toxic psycho shit. His reaction to your negative reaction says it all. It was all for him. 3 years of sex and doesn't know how to fuck you. I don't buy it. If I shoved a dick in your unprepared asshole and then was like, "Oh really, that hurt, teehee," you'd feel some type of way too. Yeah. He's only downplaying your pain and betrayal, to downplay the fact that he knowingly sexually assaulted you. I've had that accident with my boyfriend, but it wasn't deep at all and he was extremely apologetic and stopped until he was sure I was okay. Your partner's reaction is fucking weird. How would he like it if he got a dildo up his ass and you just laughed at his pain? That's not okay, and him not getting, sober, that he actually hurt you is fucked up. If you've never had anything like that before, it can really hurt, and he's so apathetic about it. I am sorry he's not getting it. He didn't miss, but it sounds like you're believing that lie. He betrayed your trust, hurt you, and is now mocking you for it. I'd make him your ex. I had this happen to me as well a couple of times, to be honest. I am 100% certain that all three times were an accident. He knew immediately that I wasn't okay every time from the first trust. The first time it happened, he didn't really realize that it hurt as people do anal. The moment he realized that I was crying, he stopped everything and made sure that I was all right. He ended up apologizing 100 times over the course of a week. Your boyfriend seems to lack empathy. Are you sure you want to be with him? Does he have that issue in other instances as well? Also, self-care is important. There are creams that help for private areas. Get it, use it well. Those things can leave a scar right there, and scars do not stretch. If ya know what I mean. Wasn't an accident. Anal is never accidental. He wanted to go on the Marmite motorway.